Yeah, I think a lot of people called it the Taj Mahal at the time. It was unusual for a lumber yard, probably not so unusual today. We had one contractor who took off his shoes every time he came in the front door. That's the kind of change it was from the old days.
The decade of the 90s saw the single greatest expansion in the 75-year history of Share Brothers Lumber, with the addition of two yards, both built from scratch, one in Shakopee and the other in Albertville.
The change starts when you start adding Shakopee and then you add Albertville, sort of becoming a company that's not sort of Minneapolis mothership and everybody's based off of it, more becoming a company as a whole and trying to transition into a company that works as a whole.
Adding capacity through new yards was just part of the growth picture in the 1990s. The building industry was changing, consolidating, becoming more complex, and requiring greater services. Our builders and remodelers wanted us to do more and offer more, and we did. Doubling our sales in the last 10 years from $100 million to more than $200 million. In the last decade of the century, Share Brothers started a whole host of new companies. A construction finance company, a land development company, a cabinet company, even a melamine storage line. We also got very serious about branding and about going after the remodeling market by becoming the first in the metro area to offer a dedicated sales force just for remodelers. In response to framing labor shortages, Share Brothers began a wall panel production facility and began installing all kinds of exterior products such as siding and windows.
Basically 9 different operating sites right now, 4 manufacturing, 5 retail sites. I look at the products and the services that we have to offer. How couldn't you be optimistic about where we're going with this?
The purchase of Justice Lumber in 2002 and our entry into the residential window replacement business were two important additions to what Share Brothers offered this ever-changing marketplace.
Second generation had such great intuition. They placed their bets well. Nowadays in business, we have to be a little bit more scientific about those bets. We can't place too many bets. We have to place fewer bets, but probably place a bigger stack of chips on each of those bets in order to have them turn out in this marketplace. And sometimes those bets don't pay off. Other times they turn into great opportunities like the Justice acquisition. Things have changed and we have to be thinking ahead, not trying to preserve the past. I like the entrepreneurial approach. 75 years, mark it in stone. You know, that's we've made it this far. We've had a great success story. But now it's almost as though we're back in the entrepreneurial stage again, where we've got to reinvent our business. We can't rely on the last 75 years, other than the core values of that last 75 years, to teach us much about the future. We've got to look at the future with big, bright eyes.